Hey, what's going on, guys? It is Jack here, and today I'm showing you my new favorite mock, and I'm completely serious when I say that. It's not like all the other times when I'm not serious. I'm serious. This is my favorite mock. I spent a lot of time designing this medieval house, which is very detailed for my standards, and I'm very happy with it. It took a long time to build, but I'm so incredibly stoked with how it turned out for how different it is from what I normally build that I just want to keep building things exactly like this. The very first thing I built was this cobblestone pathway. All the tiles and studs are laid on tiling, that way you could have things flipped upside down, and it's not locked in a grid like every single stud of LEGO normally is, which makes for a really cool effect. I love the way this thing turned out, and I will be using this technique in the future. However, it's very delicate. If I accidentally dropped this thing, cobblestone pathway would have been a pain to put back together. At the end of the pathway, there is a stone stairway that connects to the dirt road above. There's nothing too special here, just some sand green bricks for grass and a few rocks to make it look a little bit more natural. Speaking of nature, there's not that much foliage across this entire build. There's two small trees because that's all I had the parts for, and there's a few pieces of foliage up against the house itself, but there's nothing much other than that except the grass. Now, the house is actually my favorite part. You'll see that the bottom floor is using a bunch of different pieces to make the stone walls. There's nougat pieces, there's dark gray, there's light gray, there's masonry bricks, there's modified bricks, there's plates, there's hinge plates, there's trimmed plates, there's a bunch of things that go into making this, and I'm extremely happy with the way it turned out. The second floor is built in a Tudor style. It's also using some modified bricks and some plates to make it look a little bit more exciting. It's got wooden beams going all over the place and those crosshatch windows, or whatever they're called, I don't really know, but they do look pretty medieval. And the roof is using that legal technique where everything just rests down. It does come off to reveal a pretty simple interior. I didn't focus too much on the inside because I had a blast building the outside. It took me a full day to make this and I was burnt out by the end. So the inside is just a storage area, and then there is a bedroom up top. Nothing too special there, and that just slides back in so everything can match up perfectly and make a pretty good exterior. And to make it look a little bit more homey, I included some axes leaning up against the side of the house. There are some flags over on the far side by the dirt road, and I just threw in some figures to make it look a little bit more realistic, even though they're from Lord of the Rings, which is a fantasy. But that's pretty much all there is to this mock. If you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it, leave a like down below. I had a blast making this mock. It was so incredibly fun. I just want to keep going into the medieval style. If you want to see more, let me know down below. But as always, thanks so much for watching, and most importantly, take care.